Welcome to the Jab Dog Sports Talk Show, Saturday mornings, 9:30-ish. I think we hit it at 9:37 today. We're going to run for a couple hours, going to have a good old time.
A little late, but
hey,
better late than never.
We're going to talk sports, movies, clips, anything famous, anything not, anything that comes to our mind. Hosted by my man to my right-hand side here, the owner of the Chapman Law Corporation.
Batushka and Matushka.
It's Pat and Chapman.
Almost doing business as Batushka and Matushka.
I want to
be
Batushka, DBA.
Huh? I'll be Batushka.
I like that idea.
I think Matushka was the wife, was the queen, and Batushka was the czar.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I just like the way those two names bumped together. That's right. They are names of people. And we have a clip from that. What's the name of that movie, by the way, anyway? Any idea?
Nicholas and Alexandra.
Oh, that's a famous film.
Yes. I think it won a few Oscars. Yes. This is Oscars week, so we're going to have a clip from the movie The Oscar. And this is the Oscar. More from the Houston Revenge Tour show, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Look at that title slide back up there. I was kind of proud. Or happy,
we're heading into
pleased.
The NCAA tournament next week. Got to get the brackets put together. Once the brackets come out, you get your picks up on the Chab Dog competition up for ESPN.
Yeah, we've got the link is ready, so you can just click the link. You can get in there. You can get all set up and everything, and get registered.
And then see how much you can beat Chab Dog by.
Who's hosting it? ESPN? Is it ESPN's link?
Okay, ESPN.
ESPN link. Uh-huh.
Yes.
Yes, and then you can see last year, I remember how things went last year. I got off to a really slow start, but I picked up steam and I ended up beating most of you.
Yeah,
by the end.
But you didn't win one of the prizes.
No, I didn't. Just like NASCAR last week, I came in fourth, but Bubba didn't
win. I got off to a fast start and flamed out. The NASCAR-type performance.
You won. You won last week. What are you talking about?
I know, I won last week, but I start out hot.
Oh.
And then cooled down. That same thing happened last year. I think I had a streak where I got points in like four
straight
months.
Yes, you did. I had zero for many weeks, and you were racking it up, and then you had a dry spell. And
I'm feeling the mojo right now. Mm-hmm. Well, you got to go with the flow if you
get
feel
it. While you can.
Yeah, so we're going to talk a lot of NCAA. We've also got the NBA heating up. Team's starting to the rubber's hitting the road here. You better put some wins together or you're going to find yourself on the outside looking in on the playoffs, some hockey, maybe a little baseball, and the football talks. We can certainly ponder whether Aaron Rodgers is going to be in New York next year with the Jets.
Yeah, that's heating
interesting
up.
Thought there with that. Because the Jets really, they've got a good defense. And I think that might be an option for him if they can do a better job with the offensive line, protect him. That could work out.
I just find ironic that the Jets become the graveyard for Green Bay quarterbacks like they did with Brett Favre. So first Brett Favre and now Aaron Rodgers?
Yeah.
That's kind of weird, isn't it?
Well, I guess Aaron Rodgers likes green. He's going from Green Bay to gangrene.
Okay. So maybe that's it.
Yeah.
They like both like the color green. I wonder if he'll flash dick pics to people in New York, allegedly.
Well, that's the Brett Favre incident, rumor, whatever.
Allegedly, uh-huh. Just like Beretta knocked off Betty Blakely, allegedly, but he got off.
Beretta died. Trial. That's news.
Yes, Robert Blake passed away. Rest in peace, Mr. Blake. Beretta, what else did he do?
He was in that movie In Cold Blood.
In Cold Blood.
That was one of his early things that he did. That was a great movie.
Electric Light in Blue.
Perry, I think he was Perry in that movie.
PT 109.
He was in PT, yeah.
Cliff Robertson, you pointed that one out.
He was in the David Lynch movie, Lost Highway.
Yes. Oh, he played a
played
psycho.
Played that really creepy character.
Creepy? Yeah, it makes him still like...
I wish we had that scene with him and Bill Pullman.
Yeah,
where
I'm glad we don't.
Oh, man.
It's really
he's
creepy,
got his
dude.
Face painted half black, half white, I think.
Uh-huh. Kind of like Frank Gorshin does. We got one of Frank Gorshin in the commercial set from Star Trek, from his appearance in Star Trek. In the original series, imagine that. You get to be a original series alumni actor. That's pretty cool.
Well, what do you want to do? You want to start off with a clip?
Sure.
We could play that Rasputin clip since I mentioned Batushka and Matushka.
Yeah, why don't we roll into that?
Yeah. Sit back, enjoy this.
Learn a little bit from history.
You might want to have a few poison cookies while you're watching it, just like
we're going to do the trailer, or we're going to do the
I want to see the scene where they kill him, yeah.
Yeah, so that's where they're all smoking.
They're smoking and they're
eating. I think they're smoking opium. It was really popular back then.
They're feeding him poisoned cookies.
Oh, like Oreos?
And he's not dying, you know. They're like, they keep giving him more stuff and he keeps eating it and nothing's happening.
Oh, I see a bottle of vodka there. You see that nice bottle of vodka he's got going there? On the
trail. Oh, yeah. Well, that was just...
Let me get the bigger view in here.
Sipping that. Yeah, I'm sure they were smoking
There we go. Well, yeah, but they're drinking... I mean, why wouldn't they drink vodka there in Russia? Here, check this out.
This is Tom Baker playing Rasputin. I think he did a very good job in this. Turn up this.
Well, they're laughing, and they continue laughing. Oh, there we go. To Batushka and...
I didn't hear it. Oh. Is it too low? The sound too low?
Yeah. Try it again.
You're not on a diet, Father Gregory.
Oh, okay, sorry. Doesn't need adjusting. Bear with me here. Okay, so this is from... What year would this be from, Chabot? What year was this set in? Yeah,
when? This was the Russian Revolution.
So what's that? So it was 1915?
1916. 1915, because they were in the middle of the First World War during this. And that was when it was crazy, because there was a revolution brewing, the First World War.
So these people we're seeing here be like the princes?
I don't know. These were just...
The members of the royal family?
Rich boys with political connections who were involved with the government, and they decided to get rid of Rasputin.
Oh, okay.
They didn't like Rasputin because he was an outsider. He came in and got the queen all on his side and was having these crazy parties and decadent. And.
He was also a soothsayer. He was a mystic.
Yeah.
He cast himself or presented himself to the court as a
mystic.
But
he was able to get the queen's son healthy. Like, the queen's son was a hemophiliac.
Yes.
And he'd have these episodes, and when Rasputin would get involved, the kid would get better.
Mm-hmm.
So she thought he was just, you know, a god.
Well, worth keeping around anyway. So she kept him around, and then they decided to get, they didn't like his influence.
Yeah, people got jealous.
What that was. Yeah. Just jealousy?
Jealousy.
So he did actually give... Maybe he was giving out free vodka. Well, here, let's find out.
Maybe he slept with too many men's wives and they...
Ooh. Yeah, there was a rumor of that, too.
Got the wrong guy mad at him.
I do have the sound working now. I hope. Yep.
To Batushka and Matushka.
There we go.
Get that clip and put it on the website.
Yeah.
I'm going to die soon, my friends. I've made my will.
Oh, hey.
I won't live to see...
Exactly.
That's
it.
Yeah. That's what we do.
Law offices of Brandon S. Chapman. Wills and estates and trusts.
The new year.
He didn't make his will with us.
It makes me angry. It's good to enjoy yourself with your friends, eh?
Okay, no.
I don't want to die.
Pretty happy about it.
Oh, and there's a guy that dresses up in drag in this, too.
It's like Russia.
It's got a little Gary Busey in it.
Father Gregory needs a woman.
Yeah, he needs a
to
woman.
To cheer him up.
Jeez. Oh, I see. Is this where he gets the drag
from? Yeah. Yeah, he's just like...
Well, yeah, this is a royal house, so in the royal house you'd have royal... Yeah, you'd have people playing there basically 24-7, like a lot of people with music.
I forgot about that.
Watching outside the castle, but they're not with it anymore. Wow, senorita.
Oh,
It's on now. Yeah. Squeal like a pig. Oh, look. That's going to be great. Oh, he turned into this guy. Oh.
I think poison works.
Yeah. It's passed out. Oh, no. Too bad.
I've been poisoned. Yeah. You tried to kill me. Mm-hmm. You all have.
Or maybe just paranoid.
You silly fools. I thought I could trust you. Silly fools. You can't even kill properly. You're too small to destroy me.
You better murder him quickly, no chance.
Look.
Cyanide!
Yeah. Boy, they're pretty happy about it.
Now get up, Prince. Get up! Try.
He is a prince.
So you try to kill me. I beg Batushka not to start this war. I know who dies. You don't die, the people die. The wise old men, the generals, the ministers, the ones who say, do this, go there. No mud on their boots, no bullets in their bellies.
Who dies in a war?
Yeah.
It was never you.
Where's your rifle, Prince? Why aren't you at the front where the blood is? I'm not a German. I come from the Russian soil. And you fools will never destroy me. Thank God. Russia has sons like me, and isn't at the mercy of scum like you!
It's not over, though. There's more, because the gramophone running down.
We're trying to kill Rasputin. He's not your normal person.
He's not dead yet. One of those. It's gonna be funny.
We must get rid of his body.
He's not even there.
Wow, that's a nice looking carriage. It's like the Porsche of its day. Mm. Oh, he's still alive. Oh, he's poisoned and shot, and he's still going.
Right. Well, he was superhuman.
There we go. Hear that? That's from A Day in the Life at the end.
Wow. The Beatles.
Yeah.
At the very end of the song?
Yeah. Took it a little different direction.
I don't know.
Never everything in the air. It's rather dramatic music. I'm laughing, of course.
I'm like trying to beat Steph Curry in the game. A lot of shots.
I don't think he needs a change. Yeah, I guess he's going to. Oh, they're going to whip him, I think. Oh, wow. No wonder they just decided to decapitate all these royals here. That's suspicious. He's already dead, dude.
God bless the Tsar.
Hey, man. But, come on.
Okay.
What's that sign say? You suck.
What? Nicholas and Alexandra.
Yeah. All right. Well, then there's that.
Mm-hmm. So that got nominated for an Oscar, I think, and won something.
Wow.
And then, of course, we have the movie The Oscar, and that was with Jill St. John.
That nobody's ever heard of either. The Oscar.
Stephen Boyd's the main character in that one.
Can you name anything else with Stephen Boyd? And he didn't win an Oscar for that,
He's been in a bunch of other movies, actually. The Tip of My Tongue.
Oh, yeah. That's a good movie, Tip of My Tongue.
But he was kind of a big deal in the late 50s and into the mid 60s.
Uh-huh.
And
so he did a string, and of course, it was a crossover.
And this one had Tony Bennett in
it. For Tony Bennett, yeah. He didn't act that much, did he?
Didn't act a lot, but he did. He's like,
so this is just him sort of trying it on? He didn't really seem accustomed to acting in this scene.
Oh, I don't know. I thought he did fine. What?
Oh, fuck.
We just got...
watching that. We've been blocked.
What?
I don't know. What do we... I didn't see it fast enough. Damn it. What were we just playing? What was the last thing we played?
Nicholas and Alexandra.
Well, then I stopped playing it, so I don't know how... They got us so quickly. Well, we stopped playing it. We're not playing anything right now.
Mm. Well,
gee, it just tripped all. That just went really fast.
I guess that means we're banned.
Oh, no. It'll click back on here in a moment.
Okay.
This is temporary here. We're not permanently. So yeah, there we are. Now it's back on.
So they took out that whole clip?
I don't know what they took out.
Well, we just watched Rasputin die after eating poison cookies and getting beaten to death with a chain and shot about 20 times.
Yeah, it was okay until it wasn't. I mean, I was keeping an eye on it.
And I said that was like watching the Golden State Warriors go down. It takes a lot of shots, and you have to keep hitting them. You got to keep at it and stay on top of the situation, or otherwise they might get away. So, all right, well, we'll move on from that. And this is, you know, the focus of this show will partly be on the NCAA tournament that's coming up. And they're going to be finishing the conference tourneys this weekend, and then the bracket gets done like magic on Sunday. So get ready to make your picks and get them in there to the Chab Dog competition.
So Sunday,
on ESPN.
So the play-in, when does the play-in start, or do we pick the play-ins too? Or
I think the play-in's on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Or when, Tuesday or Monday, or maybe Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Then the tournament starts on Thursday, and that first week is just crazy with all that basketball going on. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like it.
So, where do you stand? Do you pick after the play-in or before the play-in?
Oh, I just do everything before.
Okay.
I don't really.
So you're not concerned if you lose?
No, the play-in doesn't affect anything really, except the couple of the teams that are actually in that first round of games. Mm-hmm. But that's all taken into account when you pick your bracket. You're picking those play-ins too.
Yeah. Okay. So you got to pick the play-ins to have an active bracket.
Yeah.
You can't get in after those. And just go for the slate. You got to play the play-ins too. Okay. That sounds like fun. Well, always looking for a long shot.
I got a lot of work to do on Sunday night.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I've got to do the.
It's Sunday night. So you're saying tomorrow we should be on our computers. Making our picks then?
Yeah.
Filling out our brackets.
Because everything happens like 3 o'clock on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
The brackets come out. So I think you're going to probably see Houston as the number one overall seed.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to probably win their conference. That's not a given, but they'll probably either win it or it'll be a close game, and that'll probably be enough for them to be number one. And then to Kansas... UCLA and the other number one, I'm not sure, it might be Alabama. It'll probably be Alabama.
Mm-hmm.
And Houston's got a good team. They went to the Final Eight last year. They got this guy Sasser, who's really good, Marcus Sasser.
Sasser.
And he's a senior, and they have Jamal Shedd, who's a junior, and a couple other guys from the team last year that went all the way to the Elite Eight,
mm-hmm.
Darius Bowser. And their coach is excellent, Kelvin Sampson. And so question is, can they get it done for Houston? We came really close in the early 80s.
Yeah, let's talk about the history. So when did Houston first have a shot at, you know, make it in the Elite Eight or get into where they
were? Well, Houston actually was really good in the late 60s when they had Elvin Hayes.
Mm-hmm.
Remember Elvin Hayes?
No, Elvin Hayes.
The Big E?
Yeah.
They played that famous game in the Astrodome, UCLA in Houston.
Okay, I did hear about that. This is that game. Okay.
1968.
68. Wow.
That was at the time that was the biggest most hyped up college basketball game, and it was a regular season game in 1968 at the Astrodome in front of a lot of people.
Okay.
And so that put Houston on the map.
Yeah, put Houston on the map, and UCLA certainly didn't hurt them.
Yeah. And then, but Houston didn't get to be really good until the mid-'80s, like 83. Mm-hmm. And they had the amazing collection of players that became known as Phi Slama Jama. And I don't know if we have any clips from that.
I've got a poster from that anyway.
Very extremely athletic team. It was like a highlight reel watching them play. Because they could all dunk, Hakeem. And Clyde Drexler was faster than you could believe.
I heard that name, Clyde Drexler.
Clyde Drexler. He played for the Houston Rockets. He ended up winning a title with the Houston Rockets along with Hakeem. So they ultimately got it done with the Houston Rockets, but they had like five or six guys in that squad.
So where'd that name come from?
Somebody just came up with it during the tournament, I think, in 83 when they were dunking on everybody. And
so Phi Slama Jama?
Yeah.
Is there a fraternity or sorority even close to that? Or that's just fun, right?
Yeah.
And then 83, 84?
Yeah. 83, they lost to the Wolf Pack from North Carolina State.
Uh-huh.
Ask any of my friends. That was my greatest prediction of all time because I picked the Wolf Pack to win the ACC tournament and then to win the title.
And how much money do you have on it?
I was just a kid. I didn't bet for money.
But you would have come in big there, right?
My friend Steve Gittleson will attest to that.
Ah, Gittleson. Okay.
But NC State kept winning games by like 2 points, 1 point.
Uh-huh.
And they were winning games by fouling people and putting them on the line, and then the other team would miss the foul shots.
You noticed that, too.
And then that was the team that was – Jim Valvano was the coach.
Who?
Jim Valvano. You remember him?
No, but I like the name.
He died of cancer in 1988.
Oh, poor guy.
They created the Jimmy V Foundation.
Okay. Yeah, that's where I've heard the V, but Valvano, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Italian guy. It was just a great story. But they came in big underdogs to the Houston Cougars, who, you know, had all the athletes. That's their coach.
Yeah, who are these guys?
Guy V. Lewis.
On the left?
Yeah, that was his coach. The coach, he had this polka-dotted towel that he handkerchief he brought to every game, and he'd hold that during the games.
And the gentleman on?
And the other guy is one of his players.
Okay.
I'm not sure who.
Uh-huh.
And but they blew it then. They couldn't get it done against North Carolina State. They lost at the very end on a dunk.
Uh-huh.
Ironic.
Yeah, but Georgetown, baby.
The next year,
Georgetown.
Next year they lost to Georgetown and Patrick Ewing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Georgetown. Yeah.
The bad boys from Georgetown. So
Patrick Ewing just became unemployed this week, didn't he? He made the news. What happened to him?
He got fired as coach at Georgetown. So, you know, his brand name equity only lasted him so long.
Yeah.
He was 70, like his record was 75-109 or something.
Yeah,
I mean, think about that. That's really bad.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
You don't see a lot of 6-year records that bad.
It wasn't from lack of trying, I'm sure.
No, it's just, I guess, I don't know. He may not be a very good coach. He's a great player.
That tells you how good a coach
great
is.
Great players maybe don't always make recruiter, good coaches.
Maybe not a great coach. Maybe a bit of both. Maybe neither. I wasn't really watching the situation.
Well,
I like the Hoyas, though.
At least they beat the Cougars in 1984. But then they ended up losing. Lost a tough one the next year to Villanova.
That was a John Thompson-led team, too. A whole different level. Now he's,
John Thompson had that towel that he wore over his. They had this thing.
You know, he wore a suit too. He'd always be in a tie.
Yeah,
and a jacket on the side on the court.
Coaches of that time period did weird things with towels. The other one that did the thing with the towel was Jerry Tarkanian, who always bit his towel.
Yeah, like Frank. Yes,
isn't that weird?
That's it. That's what Tank does. Frank the Tank. He bites his shirts.
Tank bites his shirt.
Yeah. But I'm starting to think, who else does that? That's right. Tarkanian was the other one who he'd bite towels. But at least, other than that, I can't name anybody who bites anything on camera. Mm-hmm. Can you?
Well, Steph Bueller? Curry plays with his mouthpiece.
Yeah, there's a lot of guys. That's a whole different category. Mouthpieces.
I don't like that when he's got the thing hanging out of his mouth all the time and he's fiddling with it while he's shooting foul shots.
Oh, it's kind of gross. Where is it here?
Yeah. Bueller.
I saw him throw the mouse piece in a game and get ejected for it.
Got ejected. You can't do that. You can't use it as a weapon. Not that it's that much of a weapon.
So maybe Houston can, get revenge, just like Sam Houston got revenge in for the Alamo.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. A long time ago.
Well, I queued up Jill St. John now, but all right.
Oh, I want to see that.
I got to really watch and see what happens here on the YouTube side. I get upset with this. Well,
okay.
Let's just see. It could be, go from warning to off the air.
I hope this doesn't violate community standards.
Yeah, we don't want to violate. We're not trying to violate community standards here.
But she never actually takes anything. You don't ever see anything.
Well, it's not a question. Well, we'll see.
Except her shoulders.
It's detecting if it thinks this is copyright. But if it does, I mean, we'll turn it off as soon as we see the warning. Don't worry.
And here you sit on top of a glass
Boyd.
Mountain called
That's Stephen
Boyd.
Yeah, yeah. That's with Stephen Boyd.
You're one of the chosen five, and the whole town's holding its breath to see who won it.
I know.
It's been quite a climb, hasn't it, Frankie?
The movies he's with.
Down at the bottom, scuffling for dimes
guy, no,
and those smokers, all the way to the top.
It doesn't look like it.
Magic Hollywood. Ever think about it?
That's Tony
Zale. I do, friend Frankie. I do.
Yeah, that's his voice, huh? Mm-hmm.
What am I talking about, friends?
The good nights and the bad, the cheap motels and the postponed meals. It was a rough way to make a living, but it was a living. And it was all for one
cheap
and one for all. You.
Oh, so he's emceeing the
me,
show there, too.
What's that?
He's emceeing. This guy's the MC of the show.
And Laurel.
And Laurel. Okay, so that's
Laurel.
The gal. So he and this guy are basically
spieler,
pimping
Frankie.
This girl here.
Yeah. You had to keep those guys under control.
Well, yeah.
They're promoters.
They are. So you see, they're in a room full of men. I pointed this out to Chab Dog when I was talking about this earlier. The room full of men. It's a burlesque show, which is basically a precursor or a clean strip show where, well, I guess she ends up going topless, but only for the audience.
Burlesque.
They all have to pay a heavy fee to enter. I guess they'll have to drink there too. Maybe it's not even a proper bar.
Art comes to you from way back in the dawn of time, from that first little bit of art they called Eve. The kind of round and warm art that made that little
okay?
Snitch of the blind stagger start crawling around backwards.
I don't want to watch that.
I'm talking about Helen of Troy, man. About Cleopatra. I'm talking about woman, Frank.
Woman.
A woman. Wow.
We're talking about Jill St. John.
The one and only hip-switching, nice walking.
Diamonds Are Forever and...
Not to be confused with Susan St. James.
Tony Rome. No, do not confuse with Susan. Similar, though. Yeah, similar.
I know, but Jill St. John was more...
Let's hear it from Ms. Laurel.
In my view. Mm-hmm. So, did you see McLaurin's wife?
Yeah, she's in that. So she's not a redhead, and she's not that. Yeah, no, I'll pass. Compared to Susan St. James.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the nails.
Yeah.
I noticed the nails on.
Well, she's wearing wearing Steelers colors. I love it.
I know. And it's Bengal stripes, but Steelers colors.
Tiger.
I wonder if a lot of Pittsburgh Steelers executives used to vacation.
I don't know. They should play this.
Well, actually, this isn't going wrong. Maybe this isn't Pittsburgh.
The Tigers at the game.
I don't know what they did in the club, but Steelers club, I think. I think she's like channeling Ginger from Gilligan's Island really hard here. Look at the hair.
Mm.
Yeah. Well, that's Tina Louise, isn't it?
This is before Gilligan's Island.
No, this is during. Yeah, 66, Gilligan's Island.
Was it on then?
Gilligan's Island was 64.
I thought it was later into the 60s.
No, it went for three seasons, but the first season was black and white. Remember that?
Oh. Well, I watched almost every episode as a little kid of Gilligan's Island.
Okay, so then.
I was always watching that.
You know what Ginger looks like.
Ask my mom.
Look at all these dirty old men. It's our great grandfathers there.
I wonder if my Uncle Stanley was in that scene. Look at that, man. Look at her.
Oh, look at that. Oh, look, she takes it off to another layer.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, she was perfect.
Oh, here we go. Now we're down to the final.
We've almost made it home.
We paid the big bucks for it. Oh, well, there. Well, now they're getting a full view.
Uh-oh, she can take... No,
hey, we
that's
did all
it.
Right out there.
We're almost done. Oh, this feels a little light.
What's this?
I'm sorry, boys. I had some heavy expenses.
What?
You're gonna have
not
some heavy
excusable.
Trouble unless you come up with the rest of the scratch you owe us, mister.
There ain't gonna be no trouble. You see, the sheriff happens to be my partner.
Oh, sure.
Put a leg on your face. Just don't stand around and let it drip into your shoes, and I'll beat it.
You fat honey dripper. Come up with the rest of our money, or I'll
honey
strip the lard of your ugly...
Pulls a knife on him. That's where the scene ends.
What an
abrupt... Who wins the fight?
That's a good question.
Did you see the film?
I don't remember, actually. I need to watch... That's not one of those films that's on very often.
No, like ever at all.
Yeah, it was on... Turner Classic Movies accidentally, and I saw a lot of it.
Okay,
I
well,
don't
that,
remember that though.
That worked out.
Oh, that worked out.
We didn't get
nobody
still
cares.
Air. Yeah, nobody cares. We're still in the air.
Isn't that interesting? I just thought Jill St. John would be too scandalous there for YouTube. Maybe.
Well, it might be the people who own the other film. Mm. That I don't know what trips these things.
Hmm. Oh, there's also okay, Tony Rome at the beach.
Yeah, let's see if Tony Rome can get through Tony. Okay, so to carry on the Jill St. John theme here. Yeah, let's kill that. Mm. That noise is potentially a problem. Here. Oh, wait, that's not it.
That's the first clip.
That's the other clip, Jill St. John. There we are, Tony Rome. One of my favorites.
This is the let's see how many clips we can play till I get busted show.
Yeah. We're tempting. This is the we're tempting fate show. But oh, this is a nice shot. I mean, okay.
What's
so,
that?
Back in the day, and we're talking the 1960s here, when you know, coming out of the war, when stuff started getting glitzy, and this is what was making it look all glitzy. Look at that beautiful spot there. This overhead shot. This is also where Goldfinger was filmed. The part of the movie. Remember Goldfinger, Chandler?
Yeah.
Remember he's cards and. James Bond comes in, he's looking through the binoculars and watching the guy Goldfinger play cards, and this is where he was.
Where is it exactly?
It's Miami. It's on the...
that's Miami.
Miami. It's Miami Beach on the strip over here.
That's Jill St. John.
Here comes Jill St. John under the water. And, so the ocean's very warm there, yeah, unlike California here. Unlike here, where...
it's warm, so they have more sharks.
Well, they got that, too. We got sharks here, but they prefer... Yeah,
I think they got more sharks in Southern Florida.
Ocean's cold here. It's like 57 or something. Burr.
It is nice, though. I've been to the ocean.
Oh, it's beautiful there.
South Beach. It's
you can walk in anytime,
lovely.
Any time of the year, it's beautiful.
And there's Frank in his suit.
Yeah, so look at that. So dude's got a tie. He's got a hat on. At least he's getting a little bit of the shade there, but he must be hot.
Like,
jeez.
What's his message? Why would he do that?
Well, Tony Rome.
I guess he just was dying to be near her.
Well, he's a detective.
He's
dressed.
He's too exhausted from the long hours he works.
Tony Rome? Mr. Tony Rome.
All right, let's play this.
Don't you ever sleep in a bed?
Who's Nemo?
A fellow I met. He bought a few drinks I paid for.
Oh.
Come on, I'll spring for a couple.
I thought you were broke.
I got a little money from Costerman and his daughter.
You got an advance.
You getting interested in her?
She's all right. Nice hair, teeth, some good-looking odds and ends.
If you mean her figure, she bought part of it. I'll bet on it.
You'll lose.
Buy things like that.
Don't get excited. I looked, but I didn't touch. Two beers, Smitty.
Thanks for the choice.
How long you know?
You bought drinks for that for Nemo. You bought a couple drinks for Nemo, and now he buys you a beer, and you're getting upset. Come
on,
lady.
I guess she wanted a different drink. Yeah.
4 or 5 months. I haven't seen him lately, though.
I understand you took him to the customers one night. Did he get friendly with anybody in the family?
No, Rita chilled him.
Family?
Rita.
Yes, so we left early.
I love the music in the background.
Oh, yeah.
I sure would like to find him.
Cool jazz.
I can't help you. He used to have an apartment in town, but he moved.
Hmm.
He couldn't have moved to nowhere. He's got to have an address.
Somebody might be able to help you at the Floridora Club. He used to go there a lot.
Floridora
Club. How about you get dressed, I take you out.
Hey.
I wish I were dumb enough to believe this was a social invitation.
It is.
The Floridora Club, right?
Good a place as any.
Oh, I love the way I get dates. Not my sexy legs or my charm. Somebody's address.
When you're ready, wake me. I'll be right over there.
Wow.
See, he didn't even want to watch her get dressed.
Door, door, close. Yeah, we get fired for so much. Another burlesque club. Look at that. High class, though. They got banned.
Nimmo never did say what he did. I guess he was a gangster or something shady.
Really?
He wanted to marry me at first.
Wow. You weren't very choosy, were you?
Women can't afford to be. I learned that early. I started out wanting to marry a man who was handsome, rich, and witty.
I wonder how long it took her to get ready.
I got all of it.
Yeah.
It took me three husbands to do it.
More than 5 minutes.
Hello.
Watch a woman get ready.
Yeah, it's like watching paint dry. I just stop after a while because it happens. So
no, I gotta say, I have in my life done that, and sometimes it's really cool. You don't ever like it.
I don't know what you're talking about. You mean the transformation?
Like just watching what they they do with their, you know.
Yeah, yeah, okay, I guess so. Sure, if you're
their eyes and the hair, and it's just a process, but. I don't know. It was kind of. I can remember one time where it really was turning me on. You know.
Well, I hope it wasn't your sister or your mother here.
No, no.
Mr. Oedipus.
No, it wasn't. So it
okay. I hope it was somebody. I hope it was your wife.
This was pre my wife.
All right. Oh, well, so this is safe zone to talk about. We're in safe zone.
I mean, I can just remember it. It was a girlfriend I had, and sometimes I'd find myself in her apartment and I'd be watching her get ready. And
yeah.
It was like watching a doll get made up.
Yeah. If you're speaking about it like that, sure.
But it was just, it was kind of beautiful. It was just beautiful to watch a process like that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look, we got.
What's that?
On your computer there.
We have live chat.
We have live chat from Aaron Alexander.
Got some great games.
What's he say?
Kansas and Texas for the Big 12 today. That's right. Uh-huh. Virginia and Duke for the ACC.
All right. And Penn and Princeton.
Yeah, I saw Kansas, and I saw both those teams play. And Texas has got a lot of size.
Mm-hmm.
Kansas has the best player in the country, that guy Wilson, and a point guard that's really good.
Size doesn't matter in college, isn't it funny?
It matters, but not.
Not as much as it does in the
not
pros.
Not as much as you think.
Yeah, exactly.
What's more important is, like, you know, leadership and having, like, a senior that knows what they're doing or junior.
Yeah, execution and defense matters because defense, they play defense in the NBA.
Texas and Kansas, that's going to be a war. But Kansas's problem is they don't have their coach. Their coach is in the hospital.
He is. When are you going to the hospital?
At the beginning of the tournament.
What?
Before it even started.
Like a week ago?
He went in and nobody really knows why. Like
it's Kansas, Jayhawks.
My wife said that it was because
Does he have a panic attack?
She's thinking it might be a heart attack or heart problem.
Good heavens.
Yeah. I don't know.
Well, first of all, sorry for Coach, personally, as a person. Yeah,
but
be in hospital.
The team isn't saying.
Good heavens.
The team is not saying.
And
so.
Secondly, what lousy. I'm sure the coach doesn't want to be out either. What lousy timing. Oh, what a shame. So that throws a wrench into everything. Wow.
Yeah, but they're winning with the other coach, and they are talented as hell. So, they might go down, but they'll probably still be a number one seed because hopefully he'll be back. The coach will be back.
Yeah, they were going in. Okay.
Duke and Virginia, yeah, that should be a good game. Virginia's ranked higher and is probably a slight favorite, but Duke is playing better basketball than almost anybody else right now. And they got a big guy named Filipowski.
Who coaches Duke?
John Shire.
Shire.
Yeah, a former player.
Okay. What happened to the other guy who was coaching for all those years?
Krzyzewski retired.
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
So finally Krzyzewski's gone.
Yeah.
Oh, what a shame.
No, they're doing fine with John Shire, actually. Uh-huh. And I think Duke is a sleeper team that, you know, people didn't really think that this was a Duke year, but mm-hmm. I think this team could go all the way.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm about to predict that. I'm not totally sure. Let's see what happens. But I think they just slammed Miami. Miami's a good team, and they beat Miami pretty handily. So
it's Miami of Florida?
Miami of Florida.
Miami of Ohio.
Not Ben Roethlisberger's Miami.
No. That Miami's from, that's a native name, actually. Miami of Ohio. They used to own that.
And let's not forget about my alma mater, Yale, as Carlton said. Carlton pointed out, he said, Yale's already won the regular season title, so they're in.
They're in, okay.
But I guess the Ivy League tournament champion also goes. I didn't know that.
Okay. So are we going to see Yale in the Sweet 16?
What else? Oh, Penn and Princeton. Penn and Princeton are playing. Wow. That's a war because those teams are usually the other teams in the AC, in the Ivy that are good. Mm-hmm. You remember when Penn went to the Final Four? That was in 1979.
Nope, that escapes me.
They played Magic Johnson's team and they lost 101-67.
Okay. Magic Johnson, though, that says it all. Yeah, that's where size matters if you got Magic Johnson on your team.
And Princeton's always good.
Uh-huh.
Princeton runs very disciplined, usually, you know, defense, and they do a lot of backdoor cuts. And
so could they be a Sweet 16 contender?
I don't know. Anything's possible. I think, anything's possible this year. You could see an Ivy League team in the Sweet 16.
Mm-hmm.
That's my prediction. Chab Dog's prediction is the Ivies will deliver a Sweet 16.
The Ivies will deliver a Sweet 16. One of them. One of the three, right? Mm-hmm. All right.
So I'm sorry we don't have Aaron Alexander on the wall.
We have him on. Yeah, we're getting some chat with him anyway.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Matt Tully, Tony Rome.
Right.
Matt owns the place.
Ooh, he owns the place.
Oh.
Okay.
My friend here is looking for Nemo.
Where's Nemo?
Isn't that a movie? Finding Nemo?
Do you know there's a baseball player named Brandon Nemo?
Is it Nemo or Nemo?
Yeah.
Brandon Nemo?
Where's Nemo is the cartoon, I think.
That's Where's Nemo.
Oh.
But Brandon
There Nemo? Is a Brandon Nemo.
There's Brandon Nemo. Yeah.
Yeah. He plays for the...
And Where's Nemo?
I think he plays
where's
for
Nemo's
the...
Where's Nemo's the movie? Brandon
the Mets,
Nemo.
The Mets or the Marlins?
Yeah, Brandon Nemo. All right.
Okay, let's go.
He hasn't been in lately. You know where he lives? He's a good customer. I don't ask questions.
Yeah.
You think he's from out of town? I suppose. Most people in Miami have a return ticket to somewhere.
Hmm. Oh, someone just took a picture. That was.
Say, Liz, come here a minute. You know a guy named Nemo?
Yes, I think I do.
Good.
We'll find him.
Check your files and see if there's a snapshot of him in there. He's an old friend of mine. Have fun, kids. Make it while you're young.
Kids? I don't know, man. He looked pretty old. He looked older than them, didn't he?
All right.
So there's Jill St. John back to back. That actually worked out pretty well. We can talk about the bank run.
Yes. Another
temp fade again.
Symptom of our really healthy economy is
and of the
banks
YouTube,
are starting to fail.
YouTube algorithm.
Let's hope this is the only bank that failed this one recently.
Well, this isn't a failure. This isn't a problem with the economy. This is like a sector. It's like, remember in the 80s? Okay, when were you? You were in Houston in the 90s, right?
Yeah.
So a few years before there, do you remember the collapse in the oil industry in the 80s, late 80s? And there was some regional banks that went down as well. Yes, and some regional banks went down. And so that's what's happening now. With this bank, what's it called? Silicon Valley.
It's bank. A regional problem, you're saying?
It's totally regional because it's instead of the oil economy, they got overextended in the Bitcoin and virtual currency economy.
Oh, so this is just tied in with the collapse of FTX?
Exactly. And
I didn't know
from the cryptocurrencies, you know, dropping a lot in value anyway, and from other those companies failing and other ones getting. If not failed, slowed down.
So that's why banks stay away from crypto.
Well, that's why smart banks stay away from crypto. This one wasn't smart.
Okay.
But this is what a bank run looks
like. Well, listen to this show and you find out all sorts of things.
So I believe, so back to, you could look at this and say, it looks bad. Because any time a bank fails, it's bad. But, and it's bad, still bad, but it's going to be limited to just the cryptos.
Don't look now, but there's something funny going on over there at the bank, George.
Something funny.
I've never really seen one, but that's got all the earmarks of being a run.
It's a Wonderful Life.
Yes.
Movie everybody sees every Christmas.
Yes, yes. And we're not trying to tempt fate here with the YouTube copyright or anything. We just want to look at the show. This is the perception people have of a bank run. Because pretty much is how one looks.
Just remember that this...
And this was spurred because
there's
nothing wrong with his bank, the actual bank in town, because he's a thrift. But the bank in town, it failed. So when it failed, everyone got panicky and wanted to take their money out of every institution that was there, including
this is classic
his.
Jimmy Stewart.
This thing isn't as black
classic.
As it appeared.
Just remember.
Bomb the Japanese.
I have some news for you, folks. I was just talking to old man Potter, and he's guaranteed cash payments to the bank. The bank's going to reopen next week.
But, George, I got my money here.
Did he guarantee this place?
Well, no, Charlie. I didn't even ask him. We don't need Potter over here.
But I'll take mine now.
I guarantee it.
You're thinking of this place all wrong, as if I had the money back in a safe. The money's not here. Well, your money's in Joe's house. That's right next to yours. And in the Kennedy house and Mrs. Maitland's house.
Wow, a bunch of thieves, man. I see all the money's like...
You know what this reminds me of? This other clip we played from that Edward G. Robinson movie, remember? When he
for Rico?
He ran the bank. The guy ran the bank, and there was a kind of a bank run when the regulators came and were shutting him down. Remember that?
Was that the Rico clip we were playing? The black and white? I don't remember regulars.
No, it was Edward G. Robinson. House of Strangers. House of
Strangers.
Yeah, remember that?
We should replay.
Others. Mm-hmm. You're lending them the money to build, and then they're going to pay it back to you as best they can. Now, what are you going to do, foreclose on them?
I got $242 in here.
Yeah, he's in the Fountainhead.
Here, and $242 isn't going to break anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Tom. All right.
Okay, Tom.
Here you are. You sign this. You get your money in 60 days.
60 days?
Well, now,
oh, boy. Thanks a lot.
When you bought your shares.
Tom, did you get your money?
No.
Well, I did. Old man Potter will pay 50 cents on the dollar for every share you got.
Ooh.
50 cents on the dollar? Yes, cash.
Well, what do you say?
Cash.
Oh, Tom, you have to stick to your original agreement. Now, give us 60 days on this.
Okay,
thing.
Randall.
Are you going to Potter's?
Better to get half than nothing.
Potter owns it and shuts him down.
Randall, wait. Now, listen.
I mean, it's competition.
Now, listen to me. I beg of you not to
do
this.
Valuable mortgages.
If Potter gets a hold of this building and a loan, there'll never be another decent house built in this town. He's already got charge of the bank. He's got the bus line. He's got the department stores. And now he's after us. Why? Well, it's very simple, because we're cutting in on his business, that's why.
Yeah.
Because he wants to keep you living in his slums and paying the kind of rent he decides. Joe, you had one of those Potter houses, didn't you? Well, have you forgotten? Have you forgotten what he charged you for that broken-down shack? Here, Ed, you remember last year when things weren't going so well and you couldn't make your payments? Well, you didn't lose your house, did you? You think Potter would have let you keep it? Can't you understand what's happening here? Don't you see what's
picture.
Happening? Potter isn't selling,
picture.
Potter's buying. And why? Because we're panicky and he's not, that's why.
Yeah, he's absolutely right. And that's in his case, it's a solvent, which, didn't fail, and there's no problem there. It's just a liquidity issue.
So don't panic.
Up some bargain. Now, we can...
Well, but if you have your money in that bank, yeah, panic.
Through this thing.
If you had more than $250,000 on
deposit...
Yeah,
if you had more than $250,000...
Yeah. If you did, if you had $10 million, I heard one lady had $10 million. Well, she's got a problem.
All right. We've got to stick together, though. We've got to have faith in each other.
But my husband hasn't worked in over a year, and I need money.
How am I
Well, I know how you can make some money, girl.
I'm going to live until the bank opens.
I got Dr. Booster.
She's making that up.
I can't keep my kids on faith. I've got to have...
How much do you need?
Oh, wow. Look at that. They just got that from getting married, too.
Hey! I got $2,000. Here's $2,000.
So he's giving out his money, his wedding money.
So tie us over to the bank reopens. All right, Tom, how much do you need?
$242.
No, Tom, just enough to tide you over until the bank reopens.
I'll take $242.
Okay.
There you
how
are.
Does it
That'll
end?
Close my account.
Your account's still here.
Well,
that's a loan.
We've only
seen
this. All right,
Ed.
Well, I got $300 here, George.
All right, now, Ed, what'll it take until the bank opens? What do you need?
Well, it's right. Also a famous actor, the guy next to
$20?
$20. Now you're talking. Thanks, Ed. That's fine.
Oh, yeah.
All right, now, Miss Thompson, how
so
much do you want?
But it's your own money, George.
Don't mind about that. How much do you want?
I can get along with $20, all right.
$20, fine.
And I'll sign the paper.
You don't have to sign anything. I know you.
Okay, I'll take $100.
All right, Miss Davis.
Could I have $17.50?
Oh, is she famous too?
Bless your heart, of course you can have it. You got 50 cents.
She's grandma on the wall.
Seven.
We're going to make it, George.
Six.
It'll never close us up today.
Five, four, three, two.
Well, I close it
six. One. Bingo! We
made it. They made it through the day. They didn't lose all their money.
We still got $2 left. Well, look.
Yeah. So they're saved.
All right. Oh, we did hear from Blix. He says that Brandon Nimmo is a Met.
That's right.
Center
yeah,
fielder.
I knew
he was a Met. It was either a Met or a Marlin. I wasn't totally sure.
Marlin's a fish.
And then we did find Nimmo. Oh, you want to play the Simpsons?
We got this version.
Is that pretty safe to, you know, that
one? Well, again, we'll say to YouTube, we're playing this to compare it now to Jimmy Stewart. This is another reference here. In fact, I'm sure there are many people out there watching right now or of the age group that are watching that never saw It's a Wonderful Life and have no idea, but they know what this is.
I'm going to be right back. I have to go to my office for a second.
What do you mean the bank is out of money? Yes. Insolvent!
I'll be back.
Definitely for the commercials.
Yes. Well, we still have another 8 minutes for the commercials.
You only have enough cash for the next three customers!
As there, he's playing games behind. Oh, there's Kitty. I was wondering where Kitty was. His. He's a boy. Bless you.
Just a second here.
There's Jimmy Stewart there. There's the Jimmy Stewart as a cartoon character. Somebody's voice.
Oh, no, I don't have your money here. It's in Bill's house and Fred's house.
Hey, what the hell are you doing with my money in your house, Fred?
Yeah. Even women fighting. Okay, that was funny. I thought that was funny. The chab dog thought that was funny. Geez, too bad I can't swing the camera around and show you the cat, but there he is. He's come out. What else we got going here? Oh, so what we have in the week here? There was revisionist history with regards to the tape on January 6th. So now it's showing the same video evidence that was used to convict all these people is now being used to exonerate them, which is kind of weird. I'm just really confused how the same evidence can be, same videotape can be used two ways. It's confusing. But if it can't, you know, is it that big a deal walking through the Capitol uninvited? Yeah, it is. You should serve some jail time. Now, there he is. Here comes the star of the show. This is sweet Jerry Cat. Jerry Kitty. Yeah. He's the Jerry Kitty. How are you doing today, buddy? Mm-hmm. He's a nice tuxedo cat. He's going to turn... two. He's going to be two on March 21st. So coming up, you're still only 1 year. Yeah, you're only 1 year old. You're going to double in age in a few days there, mister. And he takes, as you can see, he takes very good care of himself. He's got a good tongue here that washes his coat very well, yeah. And you work out. Yeah, you've been working out. I see you lift some weights here. You got some good abs there going there, and you do plenty of curls here. And he's a long cat. He's got quite good length there from head to toe. See? He's on the show, Chab Dog.
Oh, he's gone there.
Yeah.
Gotta make him sound.
No, he's not ready to talk yet, but at least he's...
looks good.
He's showing us his Betty Davis eyes right now. Yeah. Who doesn't like being pet? I'm told they're a good cat. Everybody does. Oh, what else is going on this week? Yeah, so we covered the January 6th, and the same video evidence is now being used to exonerate people, which is strange. I mean, I don't know. Trespassers are trespassers. I mean, I don't think you give somebody 5 years of hard labor for trespassing, but you don't let them off either. There we go. Now, what other weird stuff was going on in the news this week? There was that. There's. Hey, don't sit on the cat, dude. I guess you're close enough. He doesn't mind.
Are you worried that I was going to kill your cat by sitting on him?
No.
Like that Sopranos episode?
Was that
remember the Sopranos
episode?
Yeah, there was
episode? Someone down there, didn't it?
That one, Christopher killed a dog when he sat on the dog.
Oh, the dog. Okay,
he came in.
It wasn't a cat.
He came in a drunken stupor. He was drugged out, and he sat on something.
Crushed a dog. Well, as long as it wasn't the big guy.
And the agony of defeat.
No, he doesn't seem to care.
He knows I wouldn't hurt him.
Nah.
Look at this. Look at this.
Oh, yeah, he's making squint eyes while you pet him, too.
He looks good. I think he looks good next to me in his black and white.
Mm-hmm. He's all dressed
You're
up
sharp,
nice and formal.
Jerry.
Isn't he? Yeah. He's a good-looking cat.
Look at that. Look at that.
Meow, 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 meow.
Got his
I hope
attention.
Bingo's not looking down from heaven and just getting really mad.
Oh, no. I'm sure Bingo's happy.
Yeah,
he's
mad. I tamed the wild beast.
Yeah. So you're good with cats after all.
He likes it. Yeah. What I'm seeing is a lot of hearings going on. There's the Republicans in the House are starting to dig into things.
Yeah. Well, but I saw some cross examination. So they were digging into the Twitter files apparently this week or whoever. Put out the news on that.
Well,
nobody's
some of the
claiming credit for it, but then
Democrats on the committee were trying to get disclosure about who was the source of certain information to reporters.
Yes, and the reporters.
And the reporter
saying,
didn't want to provide that.
No,
and what reporter ever wants to provide that?
And it was kind of odd that the press was even giving press to that.
But
don't
like,
you think
who,
so? Like, because
why
be
is
Washington
that?
Schultz,
why is
like,
that so important? Who gave the information to who?
Doesn't matter. Like, why does it matter?
During Watergate, nobody wanted to hear that. Like,
well, except for Nixon and those guys wanted to go that way and say, so it's the same way. You got Wasserman Schultz saying, well,
yeah.
I'm going to attack the people who came up with this bad news about my group instead of denying that the news is false.
The fact is, it is what it is, and the more that comes out, the better, so we know what really happened.
We have that. We apparently have multiple U.S. departments that disagree on the origins of COVID. That was part of the news this week.
Oh. Well, that doesn't look that great when we commission studies to be done and told people that they should find X, Y, and Z.
Well, we got cross purposes going here, so that's kind of odd.
Yeah.
I don't know. So same old crap in the news. At least we haven't blown ourselves up yet, and there's no new war going on, so that's the good news.
Well,
it was a slow news week. That was good news, too. We had a lot of rain here.
Besides the bank failure?
Well, that's exciting. That's exciting stuff. That's good news.
It's
you need failure.
It's wetter than shit out there. I'm sick of it.
Yeah, we've been rained on. We're rainy California.
But you know what?
Look at
the
that.
Nice part about that is that you don't have to wash your car.
Yeah, it needs washing. Boy, does it ever need washing. Yeah, look at that big puddle there sitting beneath the deck chair.
One of the hazards of living in Southern California.
Gloomy it looks out there. And here comes, somebody's out in the Duffy, but it's just, cruising around on a gloomy day.
Are we getting to the break here?
You can count it down right there.
My alarm clock's saying we must be getting close. You're close.
Yeah, we're close.
How come you haven't been doing very many sound effects today?
No, because we're going to play stuff. I can't, the sound effects also on the same computer, so I can't interrupt the screen with this, but I can do them right now.
That's the joke.
There we are.
Where's the one that says you're close? Where Arnold Schwarzenegger says that, remember?
I don't have a clip for that.
You don't say?
You're close.
You're close. Very close.
No. Wow. That's no.
I seem to recall hearing that in my past.
Mm-hmm. Well, maybe way back when.
You played it, but it was maybe a long time ago.
Yeah. I got,
well, all I know is you have to make another soundbite with Batushka and Matushka.
Oh, I lied. That's the one I had. I lied.
No, but Batushka has to become a clip.
Yeah, I'll have to dig that up.
That's
important. Next time I'm producing those, I'll put that on. I'll capture it because it's capturing the soundbite.
Thank you for that information, Blix. I really wanted to hear that the Bruins are losing to the Red Wings 2-0.
2-0. Hey, Red Wings, there we go. All right.
After going 40, the Bruins are starting to cool off.
Hey,
he could go.
Here come the Bruins.
All the way.
KD makes his. He says, "Here's what Blix is telling me. KD makes home debut with the Suns and then gets KD gets hurt. So what else is new? That guy needs to gain some weight. I would give him $20 to buy a pizza and gain some weight.
Oh, gain some weight. Oh, a perfect segue into our commercials now. So speaking of gaining weight, we got some great commercials today. We're going to start off with Sally Struthers when she was sort of halfway.
Do you want to make more money?
Not quite, Sally.
Not quite blown up.
She's coming. Yeah, not skinny like from the getaway either.
She's got a pretty face.
Yeah, she's got pretty mouth.
She's
Yeah.
Well, so hey, you know, you be the judge. Have a look at her and tell us.
This
what
is
you
the little girl for International Correspondence School.
Yeah, ICS. Take it away.
Do you want to make more money? Sure, we all do. So call this free number to find out how easy it is to train at home for a better career. At ICS, more than 10 million men and women have prepared for new careers without setting foot inside a classroom. And now at home, in your spare time, you can get your career diploma or even your degree. Choose from any one of these courses. High school, TV VCR repair, computer programming, auto mechanics, bookkeeping, learning the personal computer, electrician, legal assistant, animal care specialist, interior decorating, child daycare, medical dental office, gun repair, florist, teacher aide, catering and gourmet cooking, electronics, air conditioning repair, drafting, hotel restaurant management, fitness and nutrition, PC repair, or get your degree. You can major in business management or accounting. Compare your present salary with the money you could be making in any one of these careers. They'll be repeated for you at the end of this commercial, so have your pencil ready to jot down the course you're most interested in. Then call the ICS toll-free number, and we'll send you one of these exciting career packs absolutely free with all the information you need. Here are those courses again, so call today for free information.
Call now for the free information Sally Struthers spoke about. Then decide if you want to train at home for a better career to make more money or advance in your present job. Call 1-800-445-7200. Operators are on duty now to send you free information by return mail. Choose any one of these exciting careers. That's 1-800-445-7200. Call now.
Your audience is ready, so put on your dancing shoes. Reach out and touch someone.
Reach out.
Touch someone far away. Give them a call.
We have fresh ideas at Red Barn, like a salad bar for you.
This is the third time my husband went back to the salad bar. He likes to see the Italian dressing.
We got a chicken platter, too.
We like the chicken best on rainy days, because it's foul weather.
We have fresh ideas at Red Barn.
I'm having a fish fillet just for the hell of it.
Come to Red Barn now and get a regular size cup of Coke or Tab for one little penny with any platter.
We have fresh ideas for you.
My name is Brandon S. Chabner. I am a sole owner and CEO of the Law Office of Brandon S. Chabner here in Hermosa Beach, and we do corporate law and estate planning and regulatory law. And I've been in business since 2007. Before that, I worked with various law firms in Southern California and also on the East Coast, and primarily focused on corporate law. I've been an attorney since 1990. Prior to law school, I went to Yale College and was a major in political science, graduated with distinction, magna cum laude honors there. After Yale College, I went to UCLA Law School, was on law review there, enjoyed that a lot. I went to Harvard Business School and got a degree there. I'd like to be their, you know, trusted advisor and help them understand and assess the legal risks relating to their business projects. Also, I can help them be more successful, I think, by helping them move in the direction that enables their deals to get done, and whilst at the same time mitigating business risk, but also I can provide them both with legal advice and business advice.
Ever miss something special on TV? Introducing Selectivision, the new video cassette recorder from RCA.
Selectivision records any program and plays it back on any TV. You can watch what you want whenever you want.
Up to 4 hours on one cassette, not just two, but four.
RCA's incredible new Selectivision video cassette recorder, so you won't miss a thing.
So my name is Eric Sove. I'm a paralegal with the law firm of Brandon S. Chabner. And as a paralegal, I support Brandon Chabner, the attorney of the firm. Primarily with comes to trust, it's very important that trust document reflect the wishes of those that put it together. The trust is your instructions as to how you want your estate distributed and the instructions you're giving to your trustee to do that. A power of attorney allows a trusted person to take on your affairs while you're incapacitated. And in the state of California, if your estate is less than $165,000, then you don't need to have a trust. You can simply distribute those through a will. We just want to get this completed, make sure your wishes are taken care of, so the state of California is not in there taking their piece, you're not paying probate, and your beneficiaries get the most money possible in a tax-free or most tax efficient manner possible. Having representation in place is incredibly important, and this ties back to the power of attorney, because there are going to be many times in your life where you're not going to be either able to attend for medical reasons, or perhaps emergencies happen in your life. Now you can exercise that power of attorney and someone else can represent you in your affairs, so you're free to be with your family.
Come here, kitty! Chow, chow, chow!
When my cat eats Purina Cat Chow, everybody's happy.
He's a happy cat because he loves these six yummy flavors. And I'm happy because he gets a good, solid meal. So with Cat Chow, we turn on every meal. Chow, chow, chow.
Chow, chow, chow.
Mexico presents Miss Ethel Merman.
Trust is a must at Texaco. Trust is a must we know.
You wanna be able to always rely
on the gasoline, motor oil, and products you buy. In everything that we do at Texaco, we're working to keep your trust. Wherever you go at Texaco, trust is a must. So for products you can trust, come on everybody, let's hear it.
You can trust your car to the man who wears the star, the big bright Texaco star.
A great prince awakened to find he'd become a king. This new land was strange indeed, for he recognized only his fair bride Janet and his Diet Coke. Soon the king became lonely for his people, and so he invited them down.
Win a Diet Coke spring breakaway in L.A.
Can we do that?
Lonely for his people, and so he invited them down.
Win a Diet
Coke. King, this new land was strange
there.
Indeed.
It is.
Yeah.
He looks so old there. That is Paul Williams. Holy crap.
Like, can you believe I saw that?
Wow.
Just out of the corner of my eye.
For he recognized only his fair bride Janet and his Diet Coke. Soon the king became lonely for his people, and so he invited them down.
Win a Diet Coke spring breakaway in L.A.
100 lucky couples can attend the Diet Coke beach party with Janet and Wayne Gretzky.
Come to our all-Canadian beach party. Right.
Contest Canadian details at participating party. Stores.
Oh, my God. I can't believe this was ever done.
Yeah. Wow. Well, it's old. All right.
Gotta watch the show for the commercial.
My name is Tony Asali, and I started Escrow Quick in year 2000. Most escrow companies are very rude to the client and to the realtor. We educate them, we're very patient with them when they ask questions, and we stretch our hours. Uh-huh. It's not from 9 to 5. It's from 8 to 7, so we give better service and better price. That's why we've been successful. The client that I try to help is mostly the seller, because he's the one that pays everything, and he needs to pay for his moving and for all the fees, all the commission. So we do discount for the seller as much as we can. That's what makes us different than anybody. My staff are very happy staff, and I believe the happier your employees are, the more successful
you, seen this you movie?
Are, and the more happy clients movie that we making. Have.
It's not officially out though, right? Okay. We can't play
Detroit, that. Chicago, New York, Miami.
Oh, what
we're
is this?
Never like this.
I live and die in LA.
This is the city of angels. This is LA. To live and die in LA. Rated R. Starts Friday. Check newspapers for a theater near you.
March does crazy things to a guy. You get hoops on your mind, and all you can think about is making a fast break to Magnolia Hi-Fi for the Mitsubishi Big Screen Hoop Stakes. Enter to win over $250,000 in prizes, including an ultimate Mitsubishi home theater system. Plus, buy any Mitsubishi Big Screen and pay absolutely nothing till January 2002. The Mitsubishi Big Screen Hoop Stakes. Now till the end of March. Magnolia Hi-Fi, Portland and Seattle.
Do anything mechanical, but he can't open a Hamitashen box.
No, I can't. But now I got it open.
He's being way too concerned. I yeah. This is what the JCC sent me, because I am a loyal patron of the JCC in South Bay.
That's 250 calories.
Yeah. Wow. This right here is like one big bowl of cereal that I like to eat before I go to bed. So I have to go with. This is just not nutrition enough for me. So, but you should try it.
Absolutely.
Those are for you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. Hamantaschen, it is a Purim food that Jews eat during Purim, and it celebrates the holiday of Purim, where Jews were delivered from the evil Haman. This is Haman's hat right here.
Haman?
Hmm. Yeah. It was in Persia.
Haman, yes. Okay.
The king had a wicked advisor named Haman who was wanted to get all the Jews killed. But Queen Esther saved us.
I was going to say, but Esther was...
Esther was Jewish.
She was Jewish and she was Persian.
Yes.
Yes. So that was all cool. She made it cool.
Yeah.
Oh, so it tells you right there.
That
right?
Looks like a good one, man. That looks like a big one. My mom makes them too for me.
I guess here's a one for you too, Jerry.
Do you think Jerry would like a Hamantaschen?
This is Hamantaschen. This is Hamantaschen mouse. See that? Get the mouse, Jerry. Get the mouse. Yep, you got it.
You got an apricot or cherry? Mm. Cherry.
Oh, different flavors too. Wow, yeah. I didn't even notice that.
Yeah.
You want a cherry?
Yeah, you have. Mm-hmm. You got the cookie part so far, mm-hmm. but there's jelly in the middle.
Mm. Okay, close.
Or some of them have chocolate.
Wow, how decadent.
My mom makes me cherry, apricot, chocolate, and you know what the last flavor is?
Custard?
Prune plum. Really good. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He wants his cut.
Oh, I don't think you're going to eat it, Jerry. You're going to smell it, but you're probably not going to eat it.
Oh, he's going to rub against it, yeah.
Oh, hey, it's good. It's good.
He's down.
Definitely not a dog move. A dog would have bitten into that and run off.
He's a chosen cat.
Bingo liked Hamantaschen.
Did he?
Mm-hmm.
No, he's more into protein.
So this is the second hour, even more freeform than the first hour. Let's see what Blix is talking about down now. Oh,
got some more there.
He said that the we talked about KD's home debut and getting hurt. Guy's just constantly getting hurt.
Kevin Durant.
How
old is Kevin Durant?
He's getting up there.
36, 37?
I bet he's 34, 35. Let's say 35.
What do you think, he's Tom Brady?
I'm trying to remember when he came into the league. I think he came into the league in like 2010.
No, I remember KD earlier than that.
Was it earlier than that?
2007? I'm thinking. I mean, I could be wrong, but.
Let's say 2008.
I remember him.
That was when he was probably 21.
Mm-hmm.
God, that means he's 34, 35. yeah, we could. And that's just when people start breaking down in the NBA is around 35, 36. Mm-hmm. You're seeing it with LeBron getting hurt all the time. You just can't quite. They don't have the staying power. Maybe if you're a really big guy like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and you don't move as much, you can last your 40s, but that's...
He's the exception.
He was just, yeah, totally the exception.
Yeah, nobody lasted into that.
But, you know, when you have an unstoppable shot like that, you can last a long time. Like, you know, I give that hook shot, nobody can block it under any circumstances. So why can't he just keep playing, feed him the ball, and let him shoot the hook shot? But you lose your coordination.
Mm-hmm.
I got a really good hook shot, by the way. I can shoot either hand. Ask my son.
Why don't you play in the NBA? You could still be playing now. You fool.
You know.
You went to law instead.
So hey, Eric, it's the same reason why you're not doing voiceovers. You just don't know the right, you know.
You know who's excuse me. Blow.
You just don't know how to blow your opportunity. That's
right.
All.
That's right. I got to find the opportunity to blow it first, though.
That's a secret to Hollywood.
At least
secret to Hollywood.
Yeah, he told me it was going to lead to that.
Knowing what opportunity to blow.
Exactly. Yeah. So he's got to find the right. Yeah. Everyone says they'll take you there, but no one takes you there. Very few of them.
I think you know we do owe it to Abe
Miranda
that we do the racing update, or at least have one attempt to do the racing update.
Yeah, let's try it.
Can we try that?
Mash this together here, but let's play the song here. I think we need the song to get proper.
Oh, Dorothy just piped in here. Ladies, right. Something ladies. I'm trying to get in. Oh, she's trying to get in.
She's trying to get in. Yeah. Try over here.
Well, let's get Dorothy in. Sorry, Dorothy. Please.
There she is.
Beauty before everything else. Oh, I hope she didn't give up. Did she give up?
I think I saw her right there.
Know how to blow
hey,
your opportunity.
Oh, there she is.
Oh, yay.
Oh, I got you. Dorothy wearing something alluring. What is that? Is that a bathrobe?
Oh, wow.
Oh, it's her lions.
No, lions. I just go in lions today for no reason, just other than it was my outfit.
Yeah.
Looks very cozy. Well, yeah, and a good reason today because it still continues to be cold and rainy and gray.
Where are you calling from?
I'm just in my apartment.
Oh,
I just had
downtown Irvine.
Two new clients this morning.
Mm-hmm.
And then my noon one just canceled on me. He was in person. So I'm kind of bummed. That's one of the reasons why I didn't come be with you in person because I had to meet him in person. That's what happens when people don't tell you 24 hours in advance. I could be with you right now. So,
right. People, when they don't show up, they waste your time.
Well, it happens. Thankfully,
your time is valuable. We know that.
Of course.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I could have been with you and going in and out of my telehealth stuff. And then it was my in-person one at noon. It would have been tough to get back for. But it's okay. I'm
here. You're
here
now.
Via Zoom.
We got a little bit. We got some Dorothy.
Yeah.
And
we get your video up here, and we can talk some Pistons. What can you tell us about the Pistons?
I know
they're horrible.
Yeah.
But that's okay. I mean, they're just kind of. It's very clear they've given up. It's okay though. I mean,
it's okay. Yeah, you know. It's like we're in therapy. It's okay.
But there's life in the Red Wings. The Red Wings are beating the Bruins.
Yeah, yeah.
Woo-hoo. I don't like that.
Oh, that's right. Let me turn that on. Oh, my gosh. Geez, Thank you for reminding
Blix,
me.
Blix was
that's
giving us the play-by-play.
That's why I wanted to be with you today.
Yeah. Blix told us about that. So Blix was scoreboarding.
He's looking out for you guys. But you guys got to start winning games because you're running out of time.
Red Wings got to hustle their bustle. To get into the
just to get in.
Playoffs.
They're not in right now.
Playoffs?
But they're not too far out. There's still time. They're going to have to get hot.
There's a little time, like a month.
Yeah. It'd be one of these teams where they'll say, boy, they won the Stanley Cup. They got hot at the right time, Sam. Yeah.
They're definitely getting better.
That'll have to happen.
One of my Canadian friends who I met at a Detroit Lion Niner game, he said, the Red Wings are ahead of where they're supposed to be in their rebuild. And he's a Canadian. He's an Oiler fan.
ahead of the rebuild means they're nowhere near going to the cup this year and winning it, let alone winning it.
Yeah, well, they've been in the rebuild a couple of years, but stranger things have happened. You never know.
Well, are we going to do the racing update, or are we going
Right. Yeah, I was looking.
I think we should definitely play the stuff on Ukrainian women and maybe the California Golden Seals tape.
The California Golden Seals, but we are going to do the racing update here.
Yeah. So, Dorothy, just, kind of bear with us as we try to get the racing update done. But it is our...
I'm glad I'm here for that. I got to choose one.
And you know who won last week?
Who did win?
Kyle Larson got second, and I picked Kyle Larson.
Ah.
I had that feeling.
Here comes he's a demon on
wheels. I can only pick stocks like a demon, and he's gonna be chasing after someone. You like that? I just made that up. He's busy revving up the powerful Mach 5. And when the odds are against him and there's dangerous work to do, you bet your life's in racing. See it through.
Ghost Speed Racer.
He's
often flying as he guns a car around the track. He's jamming down the pedal like he's never coming back. Adventures waiting just ahead.
Ghost Speed Racer, go! All right, take it away, Abe.
It's time for some NASCAR!
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Playoffs.
Congratulations to the Chap Dog. You got second.
Do you know Miranda?
Do you even know the Miranda rights?
First, I have to read you the Miranda rights.
They're looking good for me and for him, but not for everybody else. Nobody else is bothered to get a point.
You should do impressions, I think, for people. I think it's pretty good to perform it over here.
I know. I've seen him do it so many times.
The numbies.
We talk about racing because we like racing and we talk about it.
Yeah, that's right. We do it.
Today they're racing on a tri-oval track at United Rentals in the United Rentals 500.
Oh, okay. United Rentals.
This has been going on for quite a long time. I don't know how many years, but United Rentals has had a race for a long time.
Mm-hmm. It's on Sunday.
It's on a Sunday, and this is the third race of the year.
53rd, hosted by Phoenix Raceway.
Mm-hmm. You know what United Rentals does? They make porta-potties. I think they sell porta-potties.
Really? They rent porta-potties?
Yeah, at the events.
Mm-hmm.
People have to have a porta-potty, and United Rentals has a lot of porta-potties.
Hmm.
That's and they make all sorts of equipment.
That's symbiotic relationship there. So they, I wonder if they also have an interest in the food and the liquor.
So they can.
You pay money to put the stuff in your body, and then they get paid money to take the stuff out of your body that they paid you to eat.
That would be a good business model.
Yeah, that's like a vertical integration there. They get money from both sides of the transaction. Uh-huh.
They get it going and coming.
Yes, literally. Well, no, only twice. They don't get it coming yet. We got to figure that. Okay.
Well, then if you brought in
the ladies to work the event, like those two guys were pimping that Tony Rome's girl there in the first half. But that'd be United. Does United Rental rent that? Do they rent college educated women to escort?
They do not do anything people? Like anything is illegal.
Well,
I know what you're insinuating.
All right.
Well,
vertical.
In any event, where is this being held? It's at Phoenix Raceway, right?
It says Phoenix. Okay. 1 mile low-banked tri-oval located in.
I told you it was a tri-oval track.
I
knew it was tri-oval.
And here I was thinking you were full of shit, but you weren't.
1 mile?
1 mile in Avondale, Arizona. Dorothy, do you know where Avondale is?
Avondale.
Can you give us Avondale?
Yeah, I think that because I pass that raceway when I drive over.
So is it like on the Beltway somewhere? Is it like over in Mesa or?
No, I think the other side, the west side.
West side. Like Black Canyon?
I believe, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. More like Gilbert.
Oh, Gilbert.
On the way
in
from L.A.
Okay, gotcha. 8 degrees of banking in turns 1 and 2, 11 degrees in turns 3 and 4, and 3 degrees on the back stretch. Track first opened in 1964 with the Cup Series holding its inaugural Cup Series race in 1988 with Alan Kulwicki as the winner. Alan Kulwicki, let's hear it for Alan Kulwicki. And for the lofts, as if Brandon S. Chabner, ChabnerLaw.com.
Batushka and Matushka.
Yes, for your 501c3 needs. We'll run it through there.
All right, well, that's wheels.
So now we've got to figure out who's racing here.
Okay.
I'll see if I can get to that.
So it's an Arizona race. I don't know. We got to get
Chase
a little.
Yeah, no one can take Chase Elliott. He's expected to miss 6 weeks for winning the lottery or something.
Oh, Chase Elliott's not running?
He's not running.
Oh, I was going to pick him.
Oh, well, there you go. So your streak is over.
Well, I didn't, though.
Okay.
Because you told me he's not running.
Yeah, he's not running. And Abe specifically wanted this to be mentioned. So
all right, well, what does Abe think is going to happen?
Well, I'll get his. I guess let me get the list up here first. I got to find.
Do we have a list of who's in the race?
That's what I'm looking for. I think I got it here.
Where is Abe today?
Good question.
He's isn't he with Frank, or is he on a cruise?
Oh,
is just that.
Is he on the Good Ship Lollipop? Where is he?
Oh, maybe. Let's see.
Maybe somebody can look up that, see where Abe is while I'm finding the...
Oh.
Okay, well...
I'll have to type it in, you guys.
What
hey,
are you
Justin.
Typing in?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Oh.
Oh. There, camera's up.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. All right. I'm backing up here.
Oh, you're looking at Abe's email?
I'm just trying to find it now because I'm lost.
Well, he sent it last night.
There we are. Now I found it. Kyle Larson.
Kyle Larson tops the practice leaderboard.
There we go. Okay, this is what I was looking for.
Ooh.
Thank you.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Are we going to see two Kyle Larsons in a row?
Let's see. Yeah.
It's asking a lot.
We can look at the practice results here.
Do we know who won the race last week? Kyle Larson finished second. Who won first? Who got first? I think it was William Byron.
Oh, I can't.
I have a feeling.
I just got this to load. Sorry.
Okay. Whatever. Right.
So, here are.
What does it say?
Some sensible choices. So, in terms of the last, what would this be? Practice. Well,
the leaderboard. Yeah.
Kyle Larson.
Kyle Larson's number one.
Ryan Blaney. Alex Bowman.
Oh.
Joy Logano.
Oh. Four. The Italian Stallion. Yeah.
Chase Briscoe. Oh, okay. He's starting to surface here. Number five, Brad Keselowski.
The famous Brad Keselowski.
I like how, but say how Abe says it. Can you do that?
Brad Kowalski? Is that what he said?
Kalsicki.
Kalsicki?
Yeah. I hear him say a few versions of it. That's one of them, though.
Denny Stackhouse?
Oh, yeah.
Denny Stinkhouse?
Ricky Stinkhouse. I'm sorry, Mr. Stenhouse.
Okay.
Mr. Stenhouse Sr. Yeah, this is
he's back.
Ricky Jr.
He's back to stink up the joint again.
Number seven.
Eric Amendola?
Harrison Burton.
Oh.
Where's Amendola? Oh, Amendinger.
Amendinger.
He's at number 11, too.
Oh. That's Harris who?
Magical. Harrison Burton. Wow, have you heard him before? Harrison
no. Burton? No.
How's that name?
I have a friend named Harris Rosenblatt, but that's about all.
Kevin Harvick, number nine. Eric Almirola.
There he is. Eric Almirola.
That's Almirola. It's not Almendinger. That's Almirola.
I know. I'm thinking about it.
It's Eric with an A.
Eric.
A-R-I-C.
Well, this is a race that's in Arizona. I think Eric.
Oh, first three letters, A-R-I.
Eric might be the way to go on this one.
It's very arid. There's Eric.
Okay.
Arid.
I'm going to go with Eric Almendola.
Extra dry?
Arendol Almendola.
Really? So you're taking the number 10?
Eric extra dry on a track that's extra dry will win.
And 11, okay. We got Almendinger.
Laugh at me now.
Okay.
Pay me later.
You're taking, you can pay me now, you can pay me later. You're taking Eric Almirola. Eric with an A.
Yeah. I know it's a bit of a stretch because he's only 11th.
Uh-huh. Well, that's just a one heat, dude. It's like, it doesn't really matter.
Is Thomas Byron in there?
Well, let me finish out the rest. There's some good names here. Chris Boucher. Is that Boucher?
Bobby Boucher's brother. Boucher? Yeah, he's the Water Boy's brother.
Yeah. Oh, Daniel Suarez. I can pronounce that.
Yeah.
Corey LaJoy. Oh, LaJoy. Wow, I like that name. Corey.
Corey LaJoy.
Yeah. Austin Dillon. Bubba Wallace. Yeah, I took Bubba Wallace. Thank you, Bubba, for coming in.
Okay.
But there you go. It doesn't, 16th.
It's yeah,
just,
now
so
we're
here's
getting,
all the usual
we're
suspects.
Getting too far down there. At this
I know
point.
Tyler Reddick. What can he win? Ross Chastain. He's possible. Ty Gibbs.
I don't even see Byron.
It's okay. Kyle Busch.
He's not even running, I think.
Not
why is Kyle Busch so low? God.
See, again, it's just out, you know, warming up the engine. It
is. I guess he doesn't care.
Yeah, that's right. Doesn't have to. Hey, Dorothy, can you hear us? Are you ready to throw a pick in, or you can give us your racing evaluation later?
Yo, Dorothy.
Yo, Adrian.
She disappeared.
Yeah.
She's no longer on?
I think she had a business call, if I wasn't mistaken there. So she'll come back when she's ready.
So who are you going to go with?
So Abe is taking Kyle Larson. Oh, yeah, let's go back to us here. Abe is taking Kyle Larson.
Yeah, that's a nice, safe pick.
Also note that Chase Elliott will be out for at least 6 weeks, so hold off on picking him until his return. Qualifying starts at 11 p.m. Pacific Standard on Saturday, so you won't have much of a lineup to choose, but you can base your picks after the practice run link below. Oh, okay. That was fresh information we just saw there. Okay. So that was, boom. Maybe that ran at 11. Yeah, that ran at 8 a.m. So that's late. You got the latest news, right?
Okay.
Okay, good.
What are you going to do, Eric?
Oh, yeah, I have to pick somebody. Yeah, Almendinger's at 11, so give me.
You're picking the same one I picked.
No, you took number 10. You took Eric.
Oh, I'm getting them mixed up. Who?
Yeah, exactly. You took Eric Almirola.
Yeah.
And I took AJ Almendinger. Yeah. So you're getting a Marola. I'm getting a
okay.
Dinger.
Okay.
You're getting a Rola.
Yeah,
you
like
got
my
the Rola.
I like
got
my
dinger.
Pick better, Eric.
I got a Dinger, dude. You got a Rola.
What kind of car is he driving? A Ford?
Ford. You got a Ford. I got a Chevy.
Boy, yeah, a lot of Fords.
Yeah.
Fords and Chevys. Anything else in the top 10? No.
Chevy, Ford, Chevy.
Like,
yeah.
Is there some rule that you have to be driving a...
Bubba Wallace has got a Toyota. Martin Truex has got a Toyota.
You can't have foreign cars in here.
What, a Toyota?
Yeah.
It's going... Yeah, so that's a step.
It's really dominated by three cars.
By three,
Okay, what about Blix? Do we just give him Kyle Busch?
Blix, well, he gets his chance. You know,
who'd you want? Oh.
Going with...
Kevin Harddick. Okay.
Kevin Harddick.
Did I misspoke?
What? Okay. I didn't hear it. I heard
Blix has a real hard on for Harvick.
And Stinkhouse. Yeah, he came in ninth.
Can
the,
we say that?
This morning. For Kevin Harv. Well, you know, you could pronounce the V's like a D.
Kevin Harvick.
Yeah.
Okay.
Convict. Kevin Convict.
Yeah.
In the Stinkhouse.
And Dorothy, who did you pick? Dorothy didn't pick.
Brad Keselowski and Bauman.
We can't. We have to give her the chalk, don't we, or something?
No,
or no,
she'll,
we give.
She'll get it. She's got a while here. She'll get in when she gets out.
Okay.
All right.
Well, that's all for that. We have a update.
And as far as we know, no cats died this week. So.
Mm. We have an update in basketball. Blix said that Alabama is only up 2 on Missouri at home. At halftime.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, Missouri's actually got a good team. They're they might make noise in the NCAA tournament. Alabama's obviously, you know, quite good. Ohio State is hanging tough with Purdue, but Purdue is up by 8 in the Big Ten tournament. I would say definitely go with Purdue. That's the Purdue's the class of the Big Ten this year.
Mm-hmm.
Ohio State's having a down year. They're not even going to make the NCAAs, I think.
Mm.
I think the Big Ten's kind of overrated if you really look closely at it.
Really?
not a lot to be too impressed with in the Big Ten besides Purdue. And some of, there's a few other teams that have potential, but I think they're overrated. Anything else in terms of updates? Blick, I'm looking at Blix's chat. You're blocking me, though. Okay. Yeah, don't see anything else from Blix right now.
Okay.
Yeah, my suggestion is to learn something more about Ukrainian women. Do you want to go to play the Ukrainian clip?
Go to Ukrainian women and let me get the screen back up here.
I love the accent.
Yeah, you just die for that, don't you?
It's kind of like a
melts us Western.
It's kind of like a Southern Russian accent.
Polish or
you know.
Yeah. Oh wait, on the wrong side.
A little more country. A little more
rock and roll.
Little more twang to it.
Really? Well, okay. Let's start with you. There's a few of them here. We'll just take some clips out of them to get warmed up for there.
Get a flavor.
Yeah, exactly.
What it's like to date a Ukrainian woman. I think it's an expensive proposition.
I think any, yeah.
That's what I've heard.
A couple of days with some Russians once.
I've never really done it, but. Is this a highway in Ukraine?
No, this is.
You know, I left Ukraine in the second day of war. Even then, I stay on the border 3 days. But actually, most of the territory of Ukraine, I left on the second day of war, when all the preparations, all the checkpoints was just they was in the process to make them. And today, I returned to Ukraine, and I can see that yes, Ukraine really get so much prepared.
Okay,
for sure,
here.
I cannot make video of.
Yeah,
I cannot make video.
No, and there's gas stations and no signs of the road. Okay, we're not, this isn't the part.
Is there any information being conveyed in this clip?
Yeah, where'd it go? How do we get this?
I don't know.
It's not the one I went to put up. Sorry.
Okay, you don't get a good grade for that one. I sent you better ones.
This one. That's why. Clicked in the wrong spot.
Okay. Well, that'll make a difference.
Click in the picture. There
but finally, in real life, this is totally wrong approach.
Yeah, it's
very offensive, and you don't really need to do it. We have in Ukraine the idea that men and women can pay separately for their drinks or dinner. But
what? Men and women can pay separately?
The idea has been floated, is what she said. That's all.
Yeah, that's all floated. That's not.
But that is exactly when you want 100% define the border that we are for sure not in any relationship, even in fantasy, you know? So I would say.
Okay, so if you're no relationship at all, then so like your two office workers go out, you pay for each other. Okay, that's what she means.
For all kind of things that you spend together, you spend time together, like you go to cinema, or you are going for some kind.
Go to cinema. Yeah, you go to cinema with a girl.
Yeah, let her finish.
nightclub, for restaurant, for coffee. For any kind of other things that you spend time together with each other, man is the one who need to pay for it. At the same time, there are situations when men exactly don't need to pay. Just if you come for the first or second date and the girl takes you and bring you to shopping mall and say, oh, I would like to buy these perfumes, or I would like to have these shoes, I would like to have this dress, or any other kind of things personal, which is not related to both of you, it's just something for her.
Yeah.
Personally,
all for her. Personally.
This is out of our culture exactly to pay for such things in a very, very beginning stage of relationship. So our husbands and boyfriends, they can pay for such things. This is very normal, but this should be an advanced stage of relationship. When you are living together or you are married
nice.
Or something, then it would be very fine.
So they have
but on the
reasonable
first
expectations.
Or second date,
for what
when
we pay
you
for.
Are just. Trying to get to know each other,
going
and asking to buy some things. This is totally wrong, and you don't need to pay by any means. And
Dorothy says Joey Logano.
Joey Logano. Okay, so Dorothy's gone. Joey Logano. So we're getting Dorothy on the chat here.
That this is testing of your.
She doesn't get the chalk. She gets Joey Logano.
Generosity or something? No, this is totally not. Another
Is this getting more expensive by the second every time I listen to her talk.
There's 11 minutes of this, so we can't. I think we have to fast forward through the village girl.
Need a village girl. I don't want a city girl. They think village girls are more modest.
Girl.
They are not materialistic because they're living in village. They're not aware of the things.
Yeah, don't fall for that. Don't fall for that joke.
No, they don't know the things.
Old one.
To buy some.
Girl's going to cost less. She's going to cost more.
Is totally is communication.
Like
I would really say that
wild.
This is.
Yeah, look at that one.
We see that.
What is the perfect first date for Ukrainian woman? I will ask girls on the street what do they think about that. Let's watch.
That's somebody like.
Yes.
Borscht too.
Good looking.
She needs glasses like me. Wow, look at that. Holy.
That must be pre-war because look at.
This is.
Look how beautiful that
back
scene
before.
Is.
It could be anywhere in Europe, right? There's that sort of brutalist modern architecture there. She's curvier than the building, that's for sure. Mm. But then that building, there we go. There's some nice scope right there.
Зоопарк,
наверное, мені нравиться зоопарк.
На прогулянку кудись, да, на природу. Парк, зоопарк,
можна. The comedian, the president?
The guy that runs Ukraine.
Oh, I forget his name. I know, yeah. What's his name, the guy?
I can't believe I forgot his name.
You really? Zelensky.
Zelensky.
Theodore Zelensky.
That's where Zelensky lives.
That's where he lives?
Or maybe that's where Klitschkov lives.
Yeah, I think that might be the mayor's house. That's Vladimir's place. So she wants to get it on in a restaurant?
She
looks so
uncomfortable.
So, Chabdar, where do you want to go on a first date? Let's see if you get this right.
I want to have coffee.
I want to go to In-N-Out. In-N-Out. Take me, yeah, I take my first date to In-N-Out.
Yeah. На прогулку, парк, лес.
Oh, park.
Парк, лес?
Да.
А вы пошли в лес?
Да, я бы пошла.
Oh, that could
yeah.
be, that could
при
be,
парке,
yeah,
при
that
дороге.
That could be cute.
Да. Я же просто nice гулять люблю. Чем в эти клубы, рестораны, это мне интересно уже.
Я поняла. А вы обращаете внимание, там, сколько мужчина в первое свидание тратит денег на вас?
Конечно.
Да?
Да, я обращаюсь, потому что для меня это очень важно.
Yeah. Oh, she earns good money too. Mm.
Я зарабатываю хорошо и также хочу, чтобы мой мужчина больше зарабатывал.
Мне, конечно, важно, с кем это свидание, а не где. Но первое свидание с незнакомым человеком я бы хотела.
She's real cute. Here you go. She wants coffee like you.
Выпить чашечку кофе.
I'll have a cup of coffee with her.
Remember that episode from Seinfeld?
What?
You know what coffee means.
Coffee means what?
From Seinfeld. That's the name of the episode.
Coffee I know means. Coffee is for closers.
No, coffee means sex. That's the Seinfeld. I'm just repeating what Jerry said. Yeah, coffee means sex.
Oh.
The whole episode.
I think that's...
Hey, Seinfeld. It's in Seinfeld, it's true. Coffee house in a park. She's trying to set conditions.
Легко, да. Можно, конечно, пойти в ресторан, если позволяют возможности. Можно просто поесть в мушле.
Ooh, there we go.
Oh, mussels and oysters.
Yeah,
and a gastropod.
I told you coffee means
That's
sex.
That's what
I told
you gotta
you coffee means sex.
Устрицы и мидии.
У моря закат, суши, шампанское и в конце поцелуй. Идеально. И это первое. Скажите, вы обращаете внимание, сколько денег мужчина тратит на первом свидании для вас?
Да.
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 Да, конечно.
Я поняла, спасибо большое. Знаете, это важно, сколько денег мужчина тратит на вас на первом свидании. Вы обращаете на это вообще
да.
внимание?
Ну, главное, чтобы был бы не жлоб. Вот. Просто потом дальше это не подходит.
Я хотела, чтобы меня пригласили в МАК, наверное, и вкусно покормили, потому что если парень может тебя вкусно накормить...
Oh, I like the way she phrases
Boy,
that.
They have a lot of tattoos, don't they?
It's not
they?
Just like, it's the age bracket. It's
what
this,
the hell?
But kids are, or sorry, people our age in America have, I mean, look at Abe.
Это, наверное, самое главное.
Ночь хорошее место будет куда-то пригласить на набережную.
What do we call this segment? Tits and tats?
Well, no, it's the Ukrainians, dude. In front of
like that, tits and tats.
In front of Klitschko's palace.
Nice, это вечер.
Tattletales. You know,
tattletales.
It really suck if that's been all bombed up and destroyed. You know,
То есть на прогулку, да?
Да, на прогулку.
Не обязательно там ресторан?
Да, ресторан, это можно уже на третье, четвертое.
Ага, я поняла.
What? You can go to a restaurant on the third or fourth date?
А вы обращаете внимание, сколько third денег мужчина на вас тратит на первом свидании?
Ну, это особо не имеет значения. Главное его отношение именно не материальное, а вот по поведению.
Добре, а як ви думаєте, це важливо, скільки грошей чоловік витрачає на першому побаченні?
Ні. Взагалі ні. Я ні.
Дякую вам.
It can be some restaurant, but interesting restaurant with atmosphere, or it can be just walking, but it must be interesting place, and maybe something, I don't know, maybe some sports.
Sports.
They did
some
sports.
A, here, that, there you go, Chad. That's Chihuahua sports. She's a chap dog date.
Mm-hmm. Maybe she, yeah, Chihuahua sports. That's me. I like to go to a baseball game or a basketball game. One of the best dates I went on was I took my wife to a baseball game. That was a good date.
Who's playing?
We sat right behind home plate.
Dude, nice.
The Red Sox.
Oh, yeah.
Fenway Park.
You're trying to impress her, weren't you?
Yeah, pulling out all the stuff.
But it's for me.
Maybe flying on helicopter?
Oh.
On the first date?
Yes.
Why not?
You can go up in a helicopter on the first date? What?
Вы обращаете внимание на первом свидании, сколько мужчина денег на вас тратит?
Я считаю, что я сама зарабатываю, могу как бы сама себя покормить и так далее, поэтому это не столь важно. Я думаю, это уже в будущем, когда семейная жизнь. Вот, а так, в принципе, нет.
Хорошо, спасибо вам большое.
Всего доброго.
Хорошего дня. Okay, bye.
Well, God bless you all.
Is that it for Ukrainian girls?
I don't know. Let's see.
Such a good people there in Ukraine.
Oh, there's this other one too. Yeah.
Oh, these are the really, really.
All of them. Just so proud of them.
Yes, with Maryland I-34 affidavit of support. Yes, you can do that. There is a program for that. I know some guys have been doing it. I can.
This is the law firm, Babushka Matushka. For immigration. So yeah, if you need any help with immigration, yeah, hey, we can become experts in that pretty quickly.
Particularly if you're a beautiful Ukrainian
girl. Well, if you look kind of like these women.
Sam,
here.
It's for everybody. I mean, I'll still, you know, if you.
Yeah, here we go. Yeah, we'll cover this. We'll cover this. Yeah, no, you just we'll cover this with a. Well, you cover this with a retainer, and we'll help you with.
We'll cover you with a fine tooth comb.
We'll fill in your forms. We'll take care of all your forms. We'll mark down that we're your attorney.
Don't do immigration law. I've got to give that disclaimer. So.
Oh, we don't?
Maybe we can refer them to somebody.
Really? We can't put immigration law in that corner?
I can't become an expert in one day.
Oh, you know? That's true. Well, what if you were pretty? I mean, if she's really pretty, you couldn't.
Too much liability.
Oh, okay. Well, no more immigration law. That's it for that. It's a dead end, too, really.
Okay. Well, I mean, there's.
Well, look at that. That's not so bad.
You could play this for hours, but it's not really sports related, so we'll probably have to.
Next was my Ukraine lady, and no, she's safe. Things going to be looking positive with support of AFA.
Yeah,
she's doing humanitarian work since she lost her job to a war.
Oh, what a shame. Yeah. Okay. Well, then there's that.
There's that, and what else do we got? Penn is up 1 on Princeton. That's the latest update from the Ivy League championship.
And we got some chatter from the bucket list coach.
Oh,
anything update from Cindy?
Coach, yes. 2 weeks
from today at 1 p.m. is the National Bucket List Day proclamation.
Oh boy!
At the Huntington Beach International Motor Speedway. No, at the Huntington Beach International Surf Museum.
Oh, cool.
Who's coming to celebrate? The after party is at the Hilton Rooftop Bar.
Wow.
Okay. Well, you should be all over that, Eric. Arik?
Must have been Hermosa Beach.
Yeah.
Arik. Yeah.
Yeah.
With an E, not an A.
I'll call you Arik from now on.
Yeah.
It's got a very kind of European ring to it.
And all the gold.
Do we have any other clips to play?
Oh, yeah. We didn't play the Alamo.
We didn't play the Alamo.
This notion here, that you're the only one who feels it, that Houston has to exact some kind of revenge.
Well, just like Houston got revenge for the Texicans.
Texicans, there we go. Wait, you can say that without offending anybody.
They got revenge for the Texicans for the Alamo. So, you know, the Alamo happened in like March, early March, 1936.
So,
and then the Alamo, or was it 1824? It was 1824, I think. I don't remember.
What does it say on that flag right there?
1824. But does that mean that? What does that mean? That 1824?
Means
something. I think it was 1836 was the date of the year of the Alamo.
Well, then flying a flag of 1824.
1824 signals signify something else. I don't know what.
Are those the colors of Texas?
That's Mexico. That's
Mexico, yes, but it was their flag.
So it's the Mexican flag.
Well,
that's
the flag they were flying at the Alamo when it fell. So that doesn't make much sense, does it?
I don't know. Well, you could look it up. I don't want to look it up right now.
Just play it. Watch. Okay. Maybe it makes sense as we come through.
But the point is, Sam Houston got revenge for the deaths
one next.
Of everybody.
This is what he's going to get revenge for,
mm-hmm.
is this horrible war scene. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, yeah, so these look like the Westerners.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there was Buddy Epson again.
Back.
Ruby Jones. For Social Security. This is a bullet.
Introduced the Tennessee rifle, which helped people defending the fort. David Crockett, Tennessee rifles,
to
shoot people from the woods.
And they have cartridges, so they have to refill the rifle.
We'll get the cameras.
Is this a Disney film? Didn't Disney do a lot of shows with Daniel Boone in it? No. There, that's Buddy Epson. There he is. He's killed.
That Santa Ana captured him as a prisoner. They killed him later.
Their spirits will live. There we go. Yeah,
that's the Texas flag. As long as we remember 1824, I think, was the date that. Of the Mexican Revolution.
I said 1836.
Yeah, 1836. See, I was right. March 6, 1836. Same day my grandmother was born.
Really?
Same date, March 6. She was not born in 1836, though.
No.
So
there's your part of your history lesson. The next part's going
to
be Sam.
Well, we don't need to show. We don't really have. Do we have anything for him? But
we
could play the
Waterloo
speech.
Yeah.
They had to rally the... The troops.
Oh, okay, we have the 1984 NCAA championship game.
Oh, yeah, you want to show some of that, yeah.
That's yeah, let's see if that triggers the
Houston
alarms.
And its glories.
This may very well trigger alarms, but let's just see.
Really? An old NCAA?
You just don't know.
We gotta have some
comments. Houston against Georgetown. That's a good start. Excellent start.
Lee Geddes.
And he'll attempt one, and it's all tied up.
Is that Stevie Floyd?
Yeah, nice pass like today, you know, that's
by Winslow. Michael Young. Houston is 5 of 5 from the field. Michael Jackson.
But, you know, Georgetown was just too good in this
game. Yeah, straight on after points of
yeah.
Reggie Williams.
Awesome.
Two men up in his face.
Yeah, Reggie Williams. He's a good player. And,
gets the foul also. That was some step by Akeem. I'd like to see it over. They're 0-for-4. Williams.
Okay,
and at halftime, Georgetown leads it by 10. 40-30.
There we go. 40-30 at halftime. Yeah.
They trailed early. Here's Yanklin. Big play against Jackson.
Ooh.
Beautiful play. Lob.
Oh!
Nice pass, and Michael Graham took over from there. Michael Young. Ewing again coming out from block. Alvin Franklin, that'll count. And a foul. Franklin gets it, goes up with the left hand, and makes a nice shot.
And Ewing turns that to play.
Execution by Georgetown, cut it to 5.
Wow.
And Duke.
Georgetown. That's the ball game.
Both of them are national champions. That's fantastic.
Oh, look at this. Face of disappointment.
That was the last time Houston made the finals.
Wow. All right. So, hence why they're coming back.
Mm-hmm. And then Georgetown got his taste of its own medicine. The next year, they played Villanova, and they lost in one of the best games of all time.
Really?
Yep. Never forget that.
How or why was it
1985. Because Villanova shot like 85%. I mean, nobody has shot that good in a finals. And Georgetown shot 80%. So they really should have won. Georgetown should have won, but they ran into a team that was hotter.
Mm-hmm.
You don't probably remember that, but I do. So that's a little bit of college basketball history for you. And
Setting us up for the...
setting us up for hopefully a good tournament.
Mm-hmm.
And Blick seems to think that the Big 12 is the best conference. I gotta agree with that. It's overall the best, most teams the deepest, but the ACC is gonna have something to say about this, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, UCLA. Don't forget about them. Don't go to sleep on UCLA. Probably going to be a number one seed in the West.
Don't go to sleep. You got to remember not to set your clock. No, set it back an hour.
Yes, set it forward.
No, set it back an hour.
What are you talking about, man? You're trying to fuck people up.
Yeah, then you show up late and say, I went the wrong way. No problem. It gives you everyone you got an hour.
See, 1824, Blick said, replace the eagle on the Mexican flag.
Yeah.
1824.
Thank
you, Blix. What would we do without you and your
wisdom,
your big brain?
All right, we're
coming to the end of the show. What do we want to finish with? Little George Burns?
Yeah, just in honor of all the rain we've had in L.A. This
yeah.
is fixing a hole.
Uh-huh.
And we'll see how long. We'll see if we can run it. If not, well, the show ends where mm-hmm. they tell us to turn off.
And there's another song you had after this, didn't you? You had something else.
No, that wasn't intended.
Oh.
That would get busted. So
okay.
We'll try this.
All right.
So it's fixing a hole, yeah, where the rain gets in, because all we have is rain coming in all week. So hopefully this fixes it.
There's a hole in my head where the rain comes in. Remember that? Remember that line from what song?
Sergeant Pepper's something?
I don't know, but I've heard it.
Yeah, it's from the Beatles, man. Right? Yeah, from Sgt. Pepper's. You're pulling my leg, right?
I don't remember.
Fixing a Hole. Yeah, this is a song. This is a Beatles
song.
Okay,
no, but there's some song that has this line in about a hole. There's a hole in my head where the rain comes in.
Yeah, this is it.
Oh, that's it?
You know what? Just sit back and listen.
Okay.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
1, 2. Fixing a hole where the rain comes in.
We made it through. It's just that one problem. Well, that's an impressive accomplishment, you know? We did it.